We welcome you, our live audience, and to the millions watching us from all over the world to another edition of Say Your Mind. Today we are going to be talking about family. What is family about? I mean, what's the idea of family? When you hear family, you know that you think about the father, the mother, and the children. But the thing is that all that has changed. I mean, now you have the nannies and you have the pets, and you know, so it's larger because you have to take care of a lot of people. But I have people who are going to join me here today and give us a very sound conclusion on the idea of a family. What is a family supposed to be, and what is a family supposed to be about? Please put your hands together as my guests join me upstage. Put your hands together for them.
Woman.
Please. Welcome. Wow. Okay. So, welcome to another edition of Say Your
Mind.
Thank you for joining us. Thank you for taking up our invitation. Like I said earlier, we're going to be talking about the idea of a family. What's a family about? But before we go into the details of that, I'm sure you'd like the audience to meet you. Just, you know, brief introduction. So we start from you, Brother Nebuchadnezzar.
Yes, my name is Brother Nebuchadnezzar, aka Brother Nebu, and I am the present presiding president, bishop, and founder, general overseer of Jesus Evangelical Apostolic Catholic Pentecostal Baptist and international ministries worldwide. Jesus is coming soon. Give your life to Christ. Run for Canada. Your life. Yes. The last time I was here, a couple of you were asking from CDs from our last Holy Ghost Koboko night. Yes. And I have a special CD here for somebody. That message was a very powerful message. It was titled Kotosne. You see, that message was delivered in tongues. And
Kaneza.
It was ministered in tongues.
Brother Kaneza.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Okay, I have one copy for you, moderator.
A copy?
Yes.
How am I supposed to listen to it?
The Holy Ghost will give interpretation.
It's in tongues.
It's in tongues, yeah, but the Holy Spirit will interpret as you listen. You shall be blessed. Say amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you very much for joining us. So, I'm sure it must have been an oversight you forgot to tell us about. Madam,
no,
please, let's mention.
This is Sister Shunammite. She is the one following behind me. Yes. Okay. And she's a member of a chorister in our ministry. No, in my ministry.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Sister Shunammite.
That's all. That's all.
That is it. That's all you want us
that's
to know.
All. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Next, family.
Cha-cha-cha, ndeba ikweno. Cha-cha-cha, ndeba ikweno. Cha-cha-cha, nanchori ukweswano. If I wonder this morning, you are confident.
Chief.
Yeah? Anyway, my names are Chief. Obuezi, Atakata Abuo, one of Okunano. I am also the Ababetikizu, Abayoburabua, the second of our uncle. My father was the first. And then I am Tankro. I am finally the Oso Petapitanyeluego, one of Unewe. When you walk on money, that is the beginning of this.
Chief,
thank you.
Your name, how am I
yes.
supposed to call
Obuefin Nanakambo.
Okay.
You know, I am into shifting and forwarding.
Okay.
I go from China to Malaysia to all over the world.
It's okay. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you, Chief. Thank you, Chief. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for joining us on the program. I mean, you're a very difficult man to get.
It is
very
difficult.
And thank you for the adornment anyway.
You have to be adorned.
Thank you. Madam.
Oh, this is my very lovely lord of my investment.
Oh, is that her first name? Investment.
She is my acquisition.
Acquisition.
Her name is Lolo Eunice Beatrice Nana.
Oh, okay.
She has a shop in 111.
Okay, Chief, it's fine. It's fine. It's fine. Thank you very much.
Thank.
Good to meet you, Lolo.
Thank.
Good to meet you.
This is
please.
Beautiful.
Next family.
Thank you, moderator.
You're welcome.
For this great opportunity. My name is Ayo Macaulay.
I'm an engineer and I specialize in robotics for industrial and military applications. I'm here with my lovely wife, and may she introduce herself also.
Okay.
Thank you very much, my husband. I am Dr. Mrs. Macaulay. I'm the chief supporter and member of the Mr. Macaulay Fan Club.
Amazing. Amazing.
And I am also the chief operating officer of Energy Harvesters. We are an upstream company and we operate globally all over the world. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here.
Good to meet you. Good to meet you, my colleagues. That's a very impressive resume there. Okay, so what we want to talk about today, is the idea of a family. I mean, what is a family about? I know that there are different interpretations and times have changed though, but you know, what is a family by your own understanding? Bro Nebuchadnezzar.
Yes, Libra Satata. You see, the Bible says, yes. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you for that revelation. Yes, I will tell them that. You see, the Bible, Holy Spirit, you are distracting me right now. Thank you, Holy. I will come to you. You see, the Bible says, just as the man, just as Christ is the head of the church, so also is the man, the head of the spiritual forces of his family.
I see.
Yes. You see, the Bible says that the man is the head. Okay. And every other person must queue and follow behind him.
Okay. So,
you
your
see,
point.
The Bible says that beside a man, behind a man, is behind a successful man is a successful woman.
Beside a successful man is a successful
behind
woman.
Behind a
beside.
Look, woman, look, I have told you not to interrupt me when I'm dishing spiritual truth here. Eh?
Bro Nebuchadnezzar, I think your wife.
Your role and an ideal woman in an ideal family is to be interceding.
Bro Nebuchadnezzar, yes, I think your wife has a point. Let's hear her out.
A pointless point.
Yeah. Wow. Sister Shunammite.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator.
You're welcome.
What I want to say is very simple.
Please.
Sister Shunammite. What is the meaning of this? Oh, you are trying to outshine me, Abby? Have you forgotten that I'm the one that was invited? You only follow behind me. Just to cut your praise and just go and make your pointless points.
Thank you very much. Sister Shunammite. Short.
I want to say it's very simple.
Okay.
Beside every successful man is a successful woman.
Point taken.
The ideal family you are talking about is a type of family that is based on love and mutual respect for one another.
Blood of God. Blood of God. Look, if you don't understand the topic, ask me, I will tell you. Eh? We are talking about an ideal family. And they are talking about love and mutual respect. What does that even mean? Spiritual people like us only talk about spiritual things. Eh?
Thank you very much, Nebuchadnezzar. I get your point. So the man is the head.
The head.
And he stays our head.
Just like Christ is the head of the church.
Thank you. Thank you very much. But your wife has a point. You need to clear that out.
Points.
Okay. Thank you very much. So, Chief, over to you, please.
Yeah? Try.
Chief.
Okay. Like I was saying, I'm here with my investment.
Investment.
That is my acquisition, my wife, my lord.
Okay.
She has a shop in 111 Palm Street, Abba.
Chief. Ideal family.
And then Opie Waker. Okay. Ideal family.
Yes. Thank
Adama. An ideal family, from my very, point of view, is the family where a man to go outside to go and make money and then bring back money home, and then the wife on the other hand can take care of the children, take care of the house, take care of everything, cook food. My wife in terms of cooking food is a very, very different matter altogether.
Wow.
I am telling you, she combines four heads together in one soup.
Four heads.
Is your broken? You see Mangala, you see Ewu, you see Ngwere, all together in one fell soup.
So Chief,
I'm telling you, when you begin to eat the Lord of here.
Yes, my own.
That is it.
Of the man is also needed in the house to oversee things.
Beautiful.
That is proper.
Fantastic.
See, the woman also should participate in some decision making and also pursue our dreams.
What dream are you talking about?
That's the point.
What dream are you talking about? If not, the headquarters of your dream is in my house. You understand? The headquarters of your dream is in the shop I invested for you at the Pound Street, Mahaba. And then it is to make babies when I surrogate. Currently we have 7 and we're expecting 2 more. So that everything is okay. That is all, Chief.
So your point is the man goes out.
Makes money.
Brings it home. And the woman stays back at home.
She just does what the man says. That is all. Wow. If I open investment for an Upwork, you know the side where they sell spare parts inside Upwork.
Thank you very much, Chief. I understand your point. I get it perfectly. Thank you.
That is all that matters.
Macaulay's, please.
Thank you, moderator.
Okay.
Like one of the co-panelists rightly pointed out, an ideal home and an ideal family is where there is mutual love, there is respect, there is understanding.
God be blessed.
And of course, there is cooperation amongst the man and his wife. It's also a family where the man recognizes his primary responsibility to, you know, see to the welfare, overall welfare of the home, spiritual, physical, emotional, financial.
Amazing.
Or what do you think, Jen?
I agree with you, my darling. In addition to that, a woman must recognize her role because marriage is two people having different roles but coming together to achieve something. So a woman must recognize that the man is the head of the home and she must submit to him, she must respect him, she must obey him.
I see.
And she should also support him in different areas. That is why I am the chief supporter.
Thank you. Fantastic. Okay, so I get all of the points. I mean, it's about the man ahead, you know, and the woman supporting, not as much as just following, supporting because she has a life to live too. But one thing bothers me. Times have changed. And because times have changed, you know, the world we are in currently is fast-paced. And because of that, the women need to support, you know, whatever it is that the men are doing. But what bothers me is, what happens at the point where the woman has to assume the role of responsibility? I mean, what happens at that point? How do you deal with that when she becomes the breadwinner? How do you deal with the fact that, you know, she earns more, or, you know, or she's having to bring more than the man into the family? Bro Nebuchadnezzar, I think you have some...
See, it is wrong. Look, the Bible says that the man is the head.
I get that point.
Whether or not the woman makes more money than him, it does not matter.
Wow.
What the Bible says is that the man is in charge, the man is in front, and the woman follows behind. That is the spiritual order from God. Look, the times, I know that the times are evil. Today, if I tell you what I see with my spiritual eyes, see men wearing trousers, but in the spiritual realm, they are wearing skirts. We see women wearing skirts in the physical realm, but in the spiritual realm, they are wearing trousers. This should not be.
And you see all that?
With my spiritual eyes.
Hmm.
You see, the Bible says that when a woman now begins to take and assume the role of the head, because she's making small change, it is wrong. She has displaced the spiritual order that God has already put in place.
Okay.
As such a man should come for deliverance.
Deliverance.
We hold deliverance from Tuesday in my church to Friday. From 6 a.m. to 6
p.m. I get the point.
You can come for deliverance.
Bro Nebuchadnezzar.
We shall lay hands on you.
Bro Nebuchadnezzar, it's okay. Thank you very much. You can have your seat. I mean, the solution to everything is deliverance.
Deliverance, yes.
Deliverance. Everything, deliverance. Sister Shunammite.
You should come for deliverance.
I won't be there. Thank you. Sister Shunammite.
She doesn't have anything to say.
I think she should decide that, please. Sister Shunammite, please, the point.
Thank you, sir. What I want to say is very simple.
Just simple.
Sister
Shunammite. The point.
Allow me to say my mind.
Yeah, man. Say your mind, not praise your mind. Just say your mind. Just the point.
Okay. What I want to say is that it's not as if women want to take over. But what if the man is busy chasing ministry? What if the man is busy climbing from one mountain to another mountain? declaring fasting and prayer indiscriminately on his family.
What?
You want the family to die? The woman will take over and
woman,
watch what you say in public. The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And that is what I, do you know the importance and the benefit of my spiritual gymnastic in this family?
Brother Nebuchadnezzar.
Do you know the amount of demonic invasions that have been averted as a result of my going to the mountain?
Brother Nebuchadnezzar, you subject your family to indiscriminate fasting and prayers. Is that right? Is that true?
It is not prayer.
When a man does not provide for his family, he provides excuses.
Look, Chief Ogufe. Chief,
he goes from mountain to mountain.
I hesitate to use my spiritual koboko on you.
Brother Kaneza, you can just have your seat.
It is because he's broke. Would you go? I don't blame his wife. He's broke. He does not have money.
So, Chief, what do you have to say to that?
So, what we are saying is very simple in this matter.
Okay.
A man, number worker, will he go out and will he make money and then will he bring it back home?
Okay.
So that there will be money in the house. And then the wife can look good like my lolo. Look at her now.
I see your investment.
Can you look at Nebu's? I'm a mafia. Nebu or Nebu Lisa? You said Nebu or Nebu Lisa? Look at his wife. Look at my lolo.
The point.
The point is this. This is why there is what we call women clamoring for equality all over the place. You know, certain Nefa and Nefa, it is because of people like Nebu who subject their families to this type of thing. And the what Oyibos will cause in this world, that probably fail.
It is not good for the woman to be the breadwinner of the family.
She has sense.
She can also contribute her own input too. Financially, how about morally? Men should contribute too.
She has a point.
Women have the left to train the children. And that is called woman marginalization. Men should stay in the house.
What? You have been listening to Mrs. Macaulay You have been listening to Mrs. Macaulay. You are listening to Ibo now.
I think your wife has a point.
There's no point. There's no point. Because when she starts to talk marginalization, I know this one to call it Macaulay. Look, everything about your dream is very simple. Do you understand? Okay. It is in my house that this dream comes and ends.
Chief, thank you very much, Chief. Thank you very much. Macaulay, please.
Thank you, moderator.
Thank you.
Quick point of correction. The name is Macaulay, not Macaulay.
Chief.
It's just so that you can get the point. It's okay. It's just so you get the point. Let it go. Mr. Macaulay, please.
Well, I don't think there's any dispute about the fact that the man is primarily responsible to provide for the home.
Okay.
But truth be told, despite our best efforts sometimes, we have challenges meeting financial obligations in the home. And I don't see anything wrong with soliciting help from your God-given helpmate.
Amazing.
You know, who is your wife. And our case as a family has not been any different.
Okay.
If I remember clearly, about 6 years ago, when I started my consulting outfit, I had to put in a lot of investment, and then income or revenue as at then was very uncertain, very unstable and all that. But my wife was there to support, you know.
Fantastic.
About 3 to 6 months, she took the financial burden in the home while I found my feet in business, and we were able to overcome that. So I think family is teamwork.
Thank you. There's no problem with that. Thank you. Mrs. Macaulay. Okay.
In addition, she will pray for him so that God can also bless him, so that he can also achieve his economic responsibilities in the home. Okay. You know, early in our marriage, and that's part of the things that helped us, realize that marriage is teamwork. It takes two people to help each other to achieve what they need to achieve.
My wife cooks a lot. She's helping.
Chief.
Please let me come.
Chief, please.
Thank you. You must work together and then leverage on each other's strengths while you make up for each other's weaknesses.
Fantastic. Fantastic.
Look, the Bible says, Isaiah chapter 32. No, 43.
But Nebuchadnezzar.
That is why you are broke. I wonder if I was Emma.
Brother Nebuchadnezzar, please just make that your last point. Our sponsors are waiting to
There's last point?
Yes, last word.
Okay. You see, Libra Sata.
It's your...
Last
word.
The Bible says.
Last word.
Last word.
Yes.
Final word.
Yes.
The man is the head.
Okay.
The head of the spiritual forces of the family.
No dispute.
The woman, whether or not she makes more money than him, must follow submissively behind him. That is the spiritual order from heaven.
Okay.
The spiritual mandate from God. The one that the Holy Spirit himself has established.
Thank you very
much. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank
you, moderator.
Sister
God bless you.
Keo, what I want to say is very simple.
Just say it, not praise it.
Pray!
Stop it. Say what you have to say. That is not you and your husband. They would go your brook.
Sister Shunammite, just help us with the point.
What I want to say is that beside every successful man is a successful woman. And family is in one place. Ministry is in one place. One must not cover the other. One must not overshadow the other. That is what I want to say. Pray!
Yes!
Thank you very much. Chief, your final words, please.
Thank.
Chief.
It is very simple. A man sits down at home. There will not be Abada, Trinket, George, Abuoche, Nandiotia. A man goes out to make money and bring it back home. Your shop in 111 will be functional. There will be Abada, there will be George, there will be Akwoche, Trinket, Nandiotia. Now you make the choice.
Wow. I think that's it.
The men should stay at home. The men need to spend more time with the family. Women too want to run the world.
Wow. Chief. There you have it. Macaulay's place.
Thank you, moderator. In conclusion, God has clearly delineated the roles of a man and a woman in marriage.
Amazing.
So I think we should just be guided accordingly.
Okay. Mrs. Macaulay.
I concur with my husband. He has said everything.
Fantastic. Fantastic. Okay, so a lovely audience, there you have it. I think it's simple. To the point that the Macaulay's made earlier, family is about teamwork. It's about two people understanding each other, compromising for each other, and complementing each other. And you know, that's why the Bible says that two are better than one. You know, for they shall receive a reward for their labor. When one falls, the other picks him up. And woe to him that has nobody to pick him up. So I think you should understand that the wife or the husband is there to provide you support. And you know, just be a team until we come your way another time on another edition of this program. Keep winning, keep enjoying, keep loving on your teammates. God bless you. See you again.